Functional report. Submarines detected. Repairs complete. Contact report. Contact report. Kill credit. Recon Nagasaki and Hiroshima. Recon Langkawi, finally, and Tanjung Pinang. Recon Chichijima. Without a few recon flights over, I don't think that the detection level is raised. Ah, great. Catalina supposedly hit I-15. Contact report. Contact report. Repairs complete. Expansions. Replacements taken. Refit begins. Upgrades. Repairs complete. Upgrades. Reinforcements. Portland, Alameda. Oh, this is a photo reconnaissance squadron arriving Chittagong. No submarines are ready in Hong Kong. All are still out in refit. Here's where we sank, I think, or nearby where we sank those two, that landing ship dock. Maybe it didn't sink. We slammed two torpedoes into it. That should be enough to kill the damn thing. We have three submarines ready at Shanghai. Okay, one for each patrol station. Fuzhou. Still no base force yet, so we can't put any fighters on top of it. Is this the one? No, this is the anti-aircraft brigade. At Fusan, we changed the recon. We're going after Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Hiroshima, the fortresses did not fly last turn. I wonder if it's this overstacking that caused it. Checking the weather? Well, there's weather on our end. Who knows? Severe storms. We're sending the Delta ones out of Keijo. We're going to send them after Hiroshima as well. Maybe I'm doubling up too much. Okay, maybe I'll send the Delta ones instead. Let's try, rather than hitting Hiroshima, let's go for Nagasaki. All the Delta ones. So we'll hit two targets tonight. We're still sweeping Nagasaki with one squadron of, I don't know, is it a squadron or is it a regiment? Well, squadron. Okay, and 25 sweeping Hiroshima as well. I have recon assets. Now that we have the Aussie recon assets here too, you know, I could just switch back over to these guys. Well, they don't have as good a range, but we don't need as good a range at the moment. Anyway, these guys are going to take pictures of Matsuyama. I've got the three. The F-4F-7 Wildcat squadron up here. They have recovered. I'm breaking them down to flights of three, and I'm sending them to Kochi. See what's at Kochi, at Takamatsu, and Fukuyama. I don't know what's out here yet. This one, I'm pretty sure we flew it a couple of times, and it was empty. It's perfect. It's prime target for a parachute assault. But the problem is, even if I take the damn thing, how do I get to it? In order to get up to it, I'd have to sail past the fortress guns at Oita. And I might as well just take the damn thing if he gets to shoot at me en passant. As I pass through. I don't want to run the gun gauntlet every single time. So because it's on an inland sea, maybe that's why the AI has not left a garrison on here. Because knowing that if I had to come in through Tsushima and down through this strait, I'm going to lose to the fortress guns here, either way, or to Oita. So he's pretty darn safe with an empty base down here. So we could take it by parachute assault, but I couldn't reinforce it. I don't think it's a good spot. Let's see about the others. Which if they're what their garrisons are like. All I need to know is there are garrisons here. There's one at Kanoya. All around here they all have ground units defending them. This is the only one that doesn't so far. Also, I don't know if a small flight of 3 or 4 is enough to raise the detection level sufficiently. I'm not looking for precise information for bombing information, like a 9 out of 9 of 11 or anything like that. All I need to know is if there are ground forces present. And if there are any ground forces like Oita, I can either fly more or just move on to the next target. I'm looking for open bases that we can threaten with the paratroops. So there are 5 lightnings here. I just don't know. I've been sending flights of 3 lightnings, and they've been enough to keep the detection level high. But that might be due to just repeated passes on consecutive turns. North, we haven't advanced. We're still chasing after the retreating enemy. Same thing. We're pulling back from the road here, pulling back down the road here. We're gathered here, trying to march over. Look at that, 4 miles per day. Pathetic, huh? Pathetic. Oh, I am going to pull back my fighter force from Changchun, from Harbin. I'm going to move it back over to Changchun, just because Changchun is already a level 8, meaning that it already doubles the aviation support. I am going to be bringing the transports over, and I need some place to marshal them, and Changchun might be the place to do so. It's in the back. I've got some fighter cover over top of it so that the AI doesn't just get frisky and see all the aircraft on the ground and bomb the hell out of it. And it'll give me a quick chance to rush in, grab paratroops, and launch an attack if warranted. The army is moving past Hanoi. I think they're all out of Hanoi and Haiphong now. Yep, everyone's on the road or on the railroad. We jumped some of the transports from Chittagong up to Chongqing, letting them rest before sending them onwards. With the sub-chasers showing the audacity to come into Hong Kong Harbor and now lurking around Shanghai. Where are they thinking of landing? Everything here is covered. That's fine. But I wonder if they're even dumb enough to be trying to go all the way through here on the inland, on the river. But I don't think they are, because an LSD is too big to go up the river. They had to be something small craft, and we sank them. So if he's coming here to land, well, going to be in for a big surprise. But just goes to show the urgency to, I want to kill these things off so that we can bring the dive bombers out and possibly reposition them in Hong Kong and Shanghai to give some coverage and chase, maybe kill some of those escorts. Okay, we're here. A command HQ. Let's see, can we get all the way down to Hangzhou? How nice. Off we go. We have units at, more headquarters. Okay, we'll send them, we'll launch them for Langson. Set all to march and then cancel the headquarters. This is my slingshot unit. Nothing here. We have units coming down. Let's see. They're headed for Phnom Penh. They're 14 miles on the road. Let's see if we can't aim them for Saigon. And units just entering Saigon. Oh, they're heading for Cam Ranh Bay. That's fine. Also heading for Cam Ranh Bay. Another anti-aircraft battery has arrived. We're sending them down to Saigon. The Chindits have moved into Victoria Point. 66-246. Let's put them into combat mode. Let's see if we can't clear up this situation toot sweet. Singora, The units are still packing, so I'm not going to transfer the aircraft. We didn't have much action here last turn. We're still picking away. If this is six, if each squad is approximately 10 men, that could mean maybe 62 squads left over. That's still quite a bit to kill, since we're only getting 4 or 5 per day. That's just a... Jesus, these bombers are terrible trying to wipe out the enemy. Down south, I noted that the enemy, it's more E-boats. We had an encounter with E-boat escorts again. All I'm doing is putting my submarines out on a platter. So I'm going to give it till the end of the month. If we don't see some real targets like transports, I'm going to pull out my submarines and send them to Hong Kong. Move in. More Chinese units arrive. Okay, 97th Chinese Corps. Put them into strategic mode. Strategic mode. Set all to march. That way we don't interfere with the British brigade trying to march to the south. Prome, same, they've come out. Okay. So we set all to move and set all to march. So we don't interfere with the ones that have already moved. I have Akyab. I'm quite surprised. My little squads here are somehow starving to death. I guess all this supply is just flowing past them. They can't. There's 9 supply points here, but they can't grab it. So the same problem that was happening in Timor Sea, that for some reason they just won't take the supply. So I'm going to have to pull them out and put other squads in. Over on Impal, the 11th African Division has arrived. East Africa Division. We're taking it. We're going to recombine them so that they can all move at the same rate. First, I'm going to recombine, then I'm going to order them to march to Shuibo, and then I will separate them so that they can recover, all three of them can recover more quickly. Quiet on Ceylon, submarine just heading towards Singapore. No convoy into Bombay. Convoy in, just unloading at Karachi, and one looking for awaiting escorts before coming in. Abadan loading. No other reinforcements. No reinforcements. South Africa. Torpedo check. Submarine check. Tunny. Oh, Tunny got damaged. Whoa, on the way out. She just left port. Okay. Hard luck crew, huh? Okay, Tunny. Back to Shanghai. Back to the docks. Whew. 29% on the way out. Maybe she's just a bad luck crew. Checking for O24. Everyone else is heading back. Finback coming back. Finback and Hake returning. Torpedoes check. Tunny and a few other submarines opened fire at the landing ship dock. So even though she got hit badly and is forced to return, I think she can console herself with probably sinking the LSD. All other submarines have torpedoes and will continue their patrol. One submarine encounter on the Gold Coast, but nobody exchanged fire, unfortunately. Here's the retrieval convoy heading back to Guam. In the south, here's an inbound convoy. There was some submarines detected on top of Brisbane. I don't know if they were remnants or they were escaping, but we did not exchange fire with them or did not destroy them. Here comes the Glenartney. All the transports here and battleships are finished. We could sail right now. I think I'm going to wait for the Glenartney. We'll get closer. Then we're going to sail up the coast around and then into Townsville to retrieve. Here comes the inbound retrieval convoy. I think we'll go out with them. Submarine detected. Uh-oh. Don't know what he's doing here in patrol, just blocking the area, but at least we're going to hopefully avoid him going through Vanua Lava. Here comes the resupply convoy to Guadalcanal. I have decided I'm going to pull out one of the Wren detachments. These little detachments, they have two aviation support. They're just, they originally came from Ocean Island and Ocean and Nauru. What I want to do is I'm going to pull him out, evacuate him, pull him up to Wake, and then Guam, and then drop him over on Wake Island. This is just the kind of force I need on Wake Island, so that if any fighters are going to ferry through Wake and they damage one on landing, and then the rest can fly off, and they can, having only one or two aviation squads, that's all I need to repair a damaged fighter. The retrieval, where is it? The retrieval group that from North Pacific, we retrieved the air headquarters from Adak Island. I think I'm going to find better places to use this. So I'm going to set it down to Guam instead, rather than dedicate a whole air HQ to a small place like Wake. Over on Panama, an oiler has arrived. This is kind of weird. This one came as a reinforcement and immediately needs to upgrade. That's pretty weird. That's pretty awful. So, rather than going all the way out to the islands to upgrade, I'm going to set this one for... I don't know if it'll upgrade on the island, so I'm going to drop it into Pearl Harbor, unload it, and let it upgrade there. It'll unload very quickly at Pearl Harbor, just because of the size. On the West Coast, we have Los Angeles. We have a new... Cape May. It's not a reinforcement, but I believe it was a... refit. So we're just going to load the supplies. We'll set it off for Guam. Portland also has a new tanker. Tidewater. Okay. We'll bring it down for loading at San Francisco. Loading it at Portland would just take forever, if it ever loaded. Reinforcement Alameda. Does it need an upgrade? Nope. Okay, great. Head to San Francisco. Break in. No other ships available at the moment, so we'll just have to hope that George W. Julian will be able to pick up the 114 support squads left behind by the 1st Cavalry Division. We were notified that Tacoma has finally finished building its port. It's now maximized, so the infantry division that was here, that was stuck here, okay, we're going to set all, and we're going to march them down to their mates at Santa Barbara, which are currently building the base down there. Vancouver, a whole slew of 12 ships just dropped in, getting ready for a refit. We have 4 still loading, and the other ones... yeah, they're all the same speed, different sizes, but we're going to send them off to Guam. We have a lot. That's, 70, 80 ships in here, all most of them under refit. Okay, at Guam, all of it's... once again, I'm impressed by just how many ships can load in one turn. The amphibious ships, we sort by amphibious... All 100 amphibious vessel loaded in one turn. Both companies loaded. So we're sending them off to rendezvous at Hahajima before making the push onto Chichijima. We've broken them into groups of 20 ships each. These are all amphibious. I'm not even putting an escort with these guys. I'm so lazy. I have added escorts and carriers to these transport. This is the second wave. They're a little bit larger. They're at 40 ships. Maybe I should break them down. I'm just too lazy. I'm just too lazy to click away on that and break them down to 20s. But they're following. Lead group is 192. Chichi lead. I'm not even sending the replenishment ships this time. I'm keeping them back. I don't expect to be up there long enough. Where are these transports? I kept all the ammunition ships back this time, holding them here, because I don't see the need. We're going to take Chichijima, and I'm going to retrieve all the other ammunition ships back here and get ready for our push onto the main islands. In fact, I'm not even going to bother sending the major carriers. Here's the heavy carrier group. I'm just keeping them back. I'm not even going to wear them down and send them up. Now, I want to talk about the floating dock. Remember last turn that we were talking, the floating dock was here and it couldn't repair. Now, what the hell? Remember, they had this little number sign behind. There was a number sign here too, indicating that even with the repair ships, it could not ever repair. Now, I don't know what the hell. Now it can repair. Oh, for the love of good! Are you kidding me? All right. Maybe another repair ship finished off, and they could now they can get in here and repair. I don't know. So I'm gonna take all these. We're gonna put these at high. Hi. I'm going to repair the dock and see if we can't upgrade our ships right on Guam. Otherwise, the invasion's going ahead on Chichijima. Chichijima, we are... The bombardment group has reloaded. We switched out the spent battleships, put it back, continue to suppress. All we got to do is keep him from recovering. Air raid Hiroshima. The fortresses finally launch. We are intercepted by one Nate. And we lose one to flak, damn it. But we hit the manpower. Start the fires. Nagasaki, under air attack. Burning. 7 hits. Hiroshima, attacked again. Another fortress lost. Crap. Nagasaki, bombed. Hiroshima, hit again. Lots of fires. A third fortress destroyed. Freaking heck. Nagasaki bombed again. More fires. Oh, I-33. Nope. We anti-submarine sweep, but nobody fires. Bombardment Chichijima. Great. Still hitting the ground forces, or the ground force. There's only one unit there. So we're still hitting it. Snook hit by an E-boat escort. Minor damage. Tullaby evades an anti-submarine patrol. Fighter sweep over Nagasaki. 1-0 destroyed. A Mitchell has detected the E-boat Suta. Supposedly hitting it. Fighter sweep over Hiroshima. No enemy contact. Fuchao under attack. Another enemy bomber shot down by flak. Air raid Nagasaki. Fighter sweep. Nothing. Air raid fighter sweep Hiroshima. Nothing. Singora under attack. 37 aircraft. We shoot down 4. We lose another Canadian Martlet. Air attack Alor Star. 11 aircraft fly into 69. We get 5. Oh, some of the Kate torpedo bombers. Air attack Tanjung Pinang. 1 support squad destroyed. Disabled. Another what? 1 combat squad disabled. Bombing practice, Nakhon Ratchasima. Bombing practice, Tanjung Pinang. Oh, good. This is a good raid. The Mitchells hit 4 squads and 1 support squad disabled. Ratchasima, more bombing practice. Another submarine attack. Okay, the sub chasers managed to hit I-33 3 times. Well, Better than nothing. Unfortunately, I think we're out of ammo now. I wonder if the I'll have to check to see if the mousetrap fired.